My name is Jay Meshter, and I was part of the team that developed the Flywire concept. Looking at where the carbon fiber industry is today and the composite industry isn't inspirational. Gosh, I'd love to get what they've got. They've got things that are lighter and stronger. Wouldn't that be fantastic? But they're stiff. They're brittle. They're not going to be something that maps to a foot dynamically in motion. How can we align fibers? How can we apply the same methodology to what we're doing? What we ended up really creating was a soft composite. What we wanted were lines of reinforcement or lines of support only where we needed it, rather than the sort of extra stuff that came along with pieces of material stitched together.
Flywire adds a significant amount of structure without adding weight, because we're using these really high tenacity, high tensile strength fibers. They're not your ordinary embroidery threads.
There was something that was being stitched in the embroidery machine, and I remember just watching it, kind of impressed with its accuracy in laying down fiber, and thinking, oh my gosh, I mean, maybe we could do this 2D. We don't need to do it in three dimensions to start with. This frame here ultimately became this shoe here. This was the first runnable prototype. And we're just fast-forwarding about a year and a half in this whole process. You see the yellow fiber here? This is Kevlar. And boy, we had probably one of the only spools of stitching Kevlar that existed in the U.S. because we had to talk him into drawing down Kevlar into this really super thin thread so we could run it through our embroidery machine. We broke so many needles, I can't tell you. We wrapped Kevlar around the spindles that we had to get a chisel to chisel it off. I mean, we made a wreck of the embroidery machine because we're using all these things that was never designed to be used for. But we wanted something strong enough that we could run in. We had to take this into our lab, in Nike Sport Research Lab, and put it under high-speed footage and see what was happening. We could see that these were moving with the skin. And if I go like this with my hand, you can see the skin tighten over my knuckle and then go relax. Your foot does the same thing. And so suddenly we saw something that was performing like a skin over your skin. And we'd never seen anything like that before.
My name is Matthew Nurse. I'm a senior researcher in the Nike Sport Research Lab. The advantage of Flywire is that it gives you that conforming fit, but it's also very, very strong.
We know the force loads on each of these threads, and so we know exactly how many to place and how far apart for it to be comfortable, but also give you the retention that you need.
We found a better fiber, which is Vectran, didn't degrade in the sunlight, had actually a better flex and holding its strength, and really was stronger even than the Kevlar. Considering the violence of the stitching process and then how much flex actually occurs in a pair of footwear, it was the perfect fiber choice for us. It's pretty quick that you say, well, maybe we can make a basketball shoe, maybe we can make a tennis shoe out of this. So that just was a natural extension of the project.
I think what's really interesting is it opens a whole new realm of opportunities for building lightweight products. We're working already on maybe the third generation of this, and it's going to continue to refine and get more optimally supportive and lighter at the same time.
I never got to meet Bill Bowerman, but we study him all the time. We're always working with his things, we're always pulling his archive pieces out, and I would love to have seen what his reaction was to something like this, because I'm sure in his day, building with the materials he more or less had things that were minimal. I don't know what his lightest pieces were. I'd have to go back into the archives and see how light he actually got, but I think we'd give him a run for his money.